Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning, Pastor Caleb. Happy Friday, and welcome to chapel. I'm sure you have a few questions right now. The first one is probably, Pastor Caleb, why are you outside? Don't we normally have chapel in the church building with the altar and the cross and all that other stuff? Why are we having chapel outside today? And I'm sure that your second question is, Pastor Caleb, did you steal that sweater from someone's old grandpa? And the answer is no. I just like wearing sweaters when it's nice and cool out. But why are we having chapel outside? Well, did you know that we can have church, we can have chapel in lots of different places? There's nothing special or holy about a church building. We can worship God outside, or in a church building, or in a classroom, or in someone's house. The important thing is that we're worshiping God, that we're coming together as believers to pray, to sing, to learn, and to focus on our God. So, we can have chapel outside today, and I think it's gonna be kind of fun. And I'm gonna explain another reason during the message why we're gonna have chapel outside today. Now, I'm sure you have one more question. You're probably wondering, Pastor Caleb, if you're outside, how are you gonna get all the way to the chapel to go and sing songs with us? Well, I will have to run very fast. But let's start our service like we always begin. We begin in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, shall we sing a song together? I'm gonna run, see if I can make back in chapel to chapel in time to sing with you. Here we go. Let's sing Joy to the World. More time. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. All right, boys and girls, let's learn from Jesus today. And I know maybe you're still wondering, I know, Pastor Caleb, we can have chapel outside, but why are we having chapel outside today? Well, it's because of what we're going to learn today. Today, we're going to look at a time that Jesus taught people, and he was outside. I don't know if you can see this right now, but I'm kind of on a grassy little hillside here, and that's kind of where people were when Jesus was teaching that day. They were all sitting out on the grass together on a mountainside or on a hillside and listening to Jesus teach them. Maybe you can close your eyes and imagine that. Just imagine sitting out on a nice grassy hillside with the sun in your face and listening to Jesus. Feels pretty good, right? You can open your eyes now. That would be pretty fun. One of the reasons why I wanted to be outside is because when Jesus taught the people, he pointed to a few things that were outside. So as he was teaching them, he was talking to them about worrying. And he said, hey, do you see those birds over there? Yep. Do you see them planting food in the ground and waiting for it to grow and then harvesting it and then like putting it in barns? No? You haven't seen that? Interesting. And maybe I could ask you, like, have you guys ever seen a bird like just hopping around at the grocery store and filling up his little basket with some soup and some rice and pizzas? And no, never seen that? Or have you ever seen like one of those blue Amazon trucks, right? You see it pulling into your community and it stops right next to a tree and you see a worker with like a, you know, cardboard box and he goes like that, a beep beep thing, and then he takes it and he puts it up next to the nest in a tree. Have you ever seen that? No, right? Of course you haven't, because that's not what birds do. They don't do any of that stuff. But does God take care of them? Yes, right? He does. God takes care of them, even though they can't plant stuff or harvest it. They don't put stuff in refrigerators or order things from Amazon. But God takes care of them. And God was telling the people, you know, if God can take care of the birds and they're going to be okay and they don't have to worry about stuff, isn't God going to take care of you? Right? We worry so much about so many things in life. And Jesus is saying, if God can take care of the birds, He's going to take care of you too, right? Like my children, you know that you are more important than birds, right? God takes care of the birds and they don't have any to worry about anything. So you know what? You don't have to worry either. Because God loves you. He's going to take care of you. As they were outside, after He said, check out those birds over there, He said, oh, look over here. Look at those flowers. They're beautiful, aren't they? Look at those flowers. But, you know, they don't run out to the store and buy clothes. Or you don't see them like sewing together or knitting together clothes for themselves, do you? Right? That's ridiculous. Well, when you guys get home, you know, you pull into the house and you're about to go inside, you look at one of the trees next to you and that tree is trying on a dress or a sweater or something. No, right? You don't see that. God takes care of making sure that they're okay. He makes sure that they're dressed well and that they look beautiful. And Jesus even says, like, those flowers, they're more beautiful than any clothes or anything that anyone else could make. God says, if He can take care of the flowers and make sure that they're going to be okay, isn't God going to take care of you? Those flowers don't have to worry or run to the store to buy clothes. But we worry about stuff. He says to the people, don't worry about what you're going to eat or what you're going to drink or what you're going to wear. That Christians, believers in God, they don't have to worry about that because they know they have a Heavenly Father that loves them and a Heavenly Father that knows exactly what they need. So we don't have to worry. So I want to tell you today, Jesus says to you, don't worry. You know, there's a lot of things maybe that people worry about. And I'm really, really happy that Jesus tells us today, don't worry. Because there are a lot of things in my life that make me worry. I'm worried about the future. You know, will I get sick? Will I get hurt? Will my family be okay? You know, there's a lot of like what ifs. You ever hear what if kind of questions? What if that thing goes away? Or what if that thing that I want, I'm not able to get it? Or what if that relationship gets broken? What if? We worry, oh no, what if these things happen? Will everything be okay? And God wants you to know, no matter what if you're thinking about, you're going to be okay because you have a God that loves you. And if He can take care of the birds and He can take care of the flowers, He's definitely going to take care of you because you matter more to Him than birds and flowers. How do we know that? Well, He sent Jesus to die for you. Jesus didn't give His life for birds and flowers. He gave His life for you to take away your sins, to show you how much He loves you. So He says, don't worry. I know you're tempted to worry, but don't worry. God loves you. You're going to be okay. Whatever you're concerned about, whatever's on your mind in your future, God loves you and He's going to take care of you. I want to tell you one more thing that Jesus told people as they were out on this nice hillside listening to Him. He said, you know, yeah, you're so worried about stuff and clothes and things. He said, don't store up and save up for yourselves money and stuff here on earth because it doesn't last. He says, you know, maybe insects or rodents or something might eat it or a thief might come and take it away. Stuff, earthly things, possessions, money, houses, cars, technology, clothes, all that stuff, it doesn't last. It gets dirty, goes out of style, it breaks, gets stolen. That stuff doesn't last. And God knows how much we think about those things. He says, don't set your minds all on that stuff because it doesn't last, right? You can't take it to heaven with you and eventually it'll go away. It's just temporary. He says, instead, focus on getting treasures for heaven. Focus on things that land you in heaven, on knowing Jesus, on reading the Bible, on growing in your faith. Do you know, there's nothing at all you can take with you to heaven, except maybe one thing. You know what the only thing you can take to heaven is? Other people. That's the only thing you can bring to heaven. I could get all sorts of money and cool stuff, but when I die, it's not going with me to heaven. But you know what could go with me? My family, my friends, people who live in these houses around me in my community. I could help to bring them to heaven by telling them about Jesus. So maybe instead of being so worried about getting enough stuff and being rich enough and having a lot of things, I could be more focused and concerned about bringing more people to heaven. Instead of storing up treasures on earth, I want to store up treasures in heaven. And he says, whatever you are spending all your time thinking about, that is what is first in your heart. So what's first in your heart? I hope it's Jesus. There's a lot of other things that want to be first in your heart. Popularity, money, fun, lots of different things want to be first in your heart. But the only person who deserves to be first in your heart, it's God, right? It's Jesus. Because he's the one who loves you more than anyone else. He loves you more than anything else. And he's the one who can fill up your life and make you happy more than anyone or anything else. So don't worry. God loves you. God's going to take care of you. So set your mind, set your heart, set your eyes on him. Because he loves you. Let's say a prayer about that. Dear God, I'm often worried about a lot of things. Help me not to worry, but to know that you love me and that you are going to take care of me. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, let's sing another song together.
Let's sing Go Tell It on the Mountain. While shepherds kept their watching, or silent flocks by night, behold, throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Let's pray together. We fold our hands, we'll close our eyes, we'll think about our Savior Jesus. Dear Jesus, thank you for teaching us today. Help me not to worry about my future or about anything at all, but help me to trust that you love me and that you are going to take care of me, because that is what you have promised. Help me to trust you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. All right, let's go sing another song.
Let's sing Away in a Manger. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky look down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask you to stay close by me forever, and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children
let's close our service with the blessing. And remember, when we close a service with the blessing, we're thinking about God looking down on us, smiling at us, and it's like He's putting His hands above us and saying, I love you, I'm going to bless you, I'm going to take care of you, you can trust me. So let's close with the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with His favor and give you peace. Amen. Well, thank you for coming to chapel. Thanks for coming outside with me today to join in worshiping God and singing together and praying to Him. I'm really happy that we get to do this together. Now, before we go and before I say have a great Friday and have a great weekend, I think we have to send it over to Pastor Caleb for some birthdays. Let's sing happy birthday to the people who had birthdays this week. Sing along with me. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Juliet, Miss Sotomayor, Marcella, and Sophie. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, everyone. Have a great Friday and an awesome weekend.